they're perfect. Super ganda ng Shaina na yun sa heaven. And pag nakita mo siya, baka isipin mo, goddess siya.
Diyosa!
Diyosa siya! Kaya siguro ayaw tayo si Lord. Pakita, ayaw niya pakita sa atin. Yung chuma natin sa heaven. Ayaw na muna. So baka, imamistake niyo siya as goddess. That is how awesome you are supposed to be. And that's how awesome He wants us to be. Beyond whatever we see on earth. So, imagine yung misa yung sarili, sino kayo chura ko sa heaven. Siguro may isip nyo doon, hindi ako ano doon, baka hindi ako bagay doon, etc., etc. That's why we have purgatory. And purgatory, we don't think is purgatory. It's a very sad area. Kasi it's supposed to be a happy area. And kasi, mapapurge ka doon. Kasi pagpunta mo, para pagpunta mo sa heaven, super ganda mo na. So, it's a necessary stage. Okay? So, ultimate goal is to be a saint. Ni-skip ko yung iba. Pero okay lang. Yung essentials na lang. Tingnan natin. So, your ultimate goal is to be a saint. Parang hirap niya, no? Sabi, medyo, right? Kasi pag inisip natin yung saints, inisip natin yung canonization of saints, perfection, pero no. Kasi saints are imperfect themselves. Saints, yung canonized saints natin. And, for now, don't think about being canonized. Huwag isipin yun. Yung gano'n, yung magkakaroon ng statue and something like that. You are called to be saints in your own simple way. And dati, naglalagay lang talaga sila ng statue. Parang tita, grab that to shame. Ito yung mga symbol. Ito yung mga yun na lang, mga simple facts and figures. Very material, just skip na natin. So yun nga, holidays, happy days. The original is holy days, and that's the original holiness. So holiness means happy days. So what is holiness? Kinuha ko na lang kay St. Thomas Aquinas. The virtue by which a man's mind ay nilalagay niya ng buo ang kanyang mind and ang kanyang acts. Isinasabo niyang buo kay God. Whether or not it's perfect. As long as anything you do, you give it to God. Yun yung basically point niya. Everything, you're taking a bath, you're taking laundry, you're being a mom, you're being an employee, you're being a friend, a girlfriend, kahit ano, na pwede mo i-offer sa kanya, i-offer mo sa kanya. Kahit panunod mo ng K-pop, okay lang, Korean drama and everything, isipin mo sa kanya, that's how you build a relationship with God. You can basically tell Him everything. And you cannot be a saint if you don't have prayer life. So it's very important to keep our prayer life. Actually, struggle ko rin yung prayer life, lalo na sa mga nag-shift. Diba? Kasi pa nag-routine ka, paiba-iba yung buhay mo. Paiba-iba rin yung prayer life mo. Paiba-iba rin yung oras ng mga time. In Vatican II, before Vatican II, it's necessary for you to know kasi merong malaking calling for everybody to be holy. Kasi before Vatican II, ang isip na holy lang is yung madre, pare, like that. But Vatican II, John Paul said, na lahat tayo is called to holiness. Lahat. Not no exceptions. Okay? yeah. So all Christians, ito sa CCC natin, sa Catechism Lutheran Church, all Christians in any state or walk of life, be perfect as your Heavenly Father is perfect. In other versions of the Bible, be holy as your Heavenly Father is holy. Okay? Is also, yeah, more faithful, more text. Okay. Now, punta tayo sa unhappy old days. Siyempre kung mayroong happy days, holy days, mayroon tayong unhappy and old days. Na yun nga yung goal ng teaching na to is to examine our conscience. And paano natin tatahakin tong isang buong next year na to? We don't realize it, pero yung kalendaryo natin is based on the Roman Catholic Church, right? And naka-align siya hanggang maging prepared ka sa Christmas. Maging prepared ka to the Holy Week, then after the Holy Week, back to the ordinary days. Tapos Advent, tapos Christmas. Tapos balik ulit. Because the Church wants you to put your schedule in accordance to the goal of God for you. Which we don't know, right? We take it for granted. We don't know it. And it's very important. So, ano na yung first quarter of the year, organize na yung goal ng church. Ganyan na siya. Okay, so hindi lang siya June for weddings. Okay, February for Valentine's Day. No, February is what? Preparation for Ash Wednesday? Ash Wednesday, preparation for Holy Week. Okay, bad, ano yung mga bagay na you have to be aware of, be reminded of? One is bad habits. Marami tayong ito.
Laziness.
Laziness. Laziness, anger.
Judginess.
Gossip. Envy. Or joining. Ano yun? Adding gas to the fire. Yung pag may nagchichismisan, dalagdag ka pa. It's tempting, no? It's reality. Kasi minsan, gossip is fun. It's quoted as a social thing. And lahat ng tao nag-gossip. Kaya yung ancient years, nag-gossip talaga sila. Uso talaga yung gossip. And in fairness, si Christ, sumika talaga siya sa gossip.
Word of mouth.
Word of mouth. Pero ang tanong, is the word of mouth good or bad? You have to ask yourself first. Is it good? Is it true? Is it helpful? Yun yung basic three na tinuturo ng spiritual director. If you have an information, make sure that it's truth, it's good, and it's helpful. Pag may isa doon nawawala, tumahimik ka siya. Try it. Huwag ka muna nawawal. It's good, it's good. It's true, is it true, is it good, is it helpful? Ganun din kapag na-urge ka magsabi ng something. Kung sasabihin mo ba, is good, is it true, and is it helpful?
So if not,
if
gossip
not,
siya.
Tahimik ka na muna. Kapag hindi, pag-isipan mo muna ulit.
If it's good, it's
yes.
Oh my God.
What if you're asking for help? Like, what, you're telling someone that you don't like this someone because of what he's doing.
Okay.
Then you want to know what should I do?
Merong difference sa gossip and sa
correction,
fraternal correction, which is pinapayagan ng simbahan yung fraternal correction. But you have to choose who is your corrector, okay? And your corrector should have at least mas mature siya sa'yo. Alam mo, mahirap na ma-gauge ko anong maturity, pero for me, maturity is yung experience nila sa buhay, experience nila sa certain topic na yun. So, kailangan mo siyang, iwi mo, sino yung kakausapin mo, sino yung dapat mong kausapin. And most especially, pray for it, kung siya ba yung dapat mong kausapin. Fraternal correction is only. Okay? Oh, yun, nandidiscourage na siya. Okay lang, tama-tama yung feeling niya kasi nasa unhappy oldies tayo. Ito yung time na kailangan mong harapin yung masakit at yung pangit sa'yo. Okay? The saints. Yung saints, they're the best people to go to kasi they know how sinful they are. Okay? Next, misdirection. Ano to? Aiming for goals for the wrong reasons. Such as selfishness or pride. Ano sinabi ko sa ito? Okay,
misdirection.
Sige, ito yung okay. Ito yung siguro, I would say, gusto mong... Ay! may grand entrance yung siguro sa akin na lang, example yung sarili ko. Misdirection yung, isipin mo ikaw yung magtotalk ng holiness kasi huli ka. That's misdirection. That's something is wrong. Iba yung reason mo. Mali yung wrong reasons ko to be here. Another misdirection is mistakening timidity versus humility. Sabi nila, ay, hindi ako pwede. Ayoko mag-share. I need to be humble. Humility means you are acknowledging that everything you have is God's. That's humility. timidity is being fearful. Hindi siya connected at all to humility. Pag sinabi mo, sino ulit ang marunong kumanta? And kaya mong kumanta. Pero ayaw mo, kasi feeling mo magyayabang kapag kakanta ka. Ay, isipin mo yun. That is timidity. And God did not give you timidity. He gave you fearless, boldness, you know? Saints, they all go for a mission. Lahat sila lumalabas. Whether or not they're shy or something. But humility, yun yung hinahanap natin. Na you acknowledge yourself na everything you have, whatever I have in this paper, is not mine but God. Okay? Ano pa bang misdirection sa buhay? For pursuing, siguro, sige, since we're talking about holiness, no, yung goal natin is holiness, pero you're pursuing something more materialistic or out of holiness kind of thing. And feeling mo kasi yun yung magpapahappy sa'yo. But God's mercy is bigger than our sins, okay? Sometimes we cannot blame ourselves to think otherwise kasi the society will give us this, all these ideas. Kaya nga may ganito tayong community to help us to be understand better who we are. Anong solve, pwedeng solve sa misdirection? Again, fraternal correction. Humingi ka ng help. Go to the priest. Go to the nuns. Go to the tito and titas. Go to whoever you want to say. Kailangan mo na second voice. Tama ba itong gagawin ko? Nilagay ko dito pride. Nakalimutan kung bakit ko siya nilagay. Pero ngayon tandaan ko na kung bakit siya nilagay. Pride kasi it's connected dun sa paghingi ng advice. Kasi feeling mo alam mo na lahat. Feeling mo hindi mo na kailangan ng payo. Okay? That's pride. Sa book, may isang book na nabasa, Inferno. Baka yung sa inyo alam mo yung Inferno. Dante Alighieri Inferno. Ano siya, binisualize niya yung purgatory. Sa pinaka-mountain yung purgatory, binisualize niya. Ang base nun, ang first stage nun is pride. Bakit kaya?
Pinakalalaman.
Pwede. And siya yung pinaka-basic. Siya yung pinaka-basic ng mountain. Lahat ng sins, you can link it to pride. You can link it to pride. Okay? So be aware of that.
Open.
It's impossible na malawa mo lahat. Kahit gano'ng katalito. Kahit gano'ng kaka-informed. Marami ka pa rin insights mo ang work from other people. Stagnation! Ito, paborito ko to. Paborito ko to, stagnation. Para sa mga tamad, lumabas na. Okay. Sabi sa stagnation, setting in our comfort zone, not aiming to level up, we get tired. It's okay to be tired, but if you get tired and you ditch waiting and hoping for the Lord, ibang usapan na yun. Okay? Maraming causes na may stagnation. Pwedeng character mo siya, personality mo siya, hormones mo siya, may period ka, malungkot ka lang talaga, or kakanood mo lang kang malungkot na K-pop at gusto mo siyang namnamin. And totally, gusto mo talaga ngayon. But again, this is not what God wants us to do. He wants us to move. I put here water kasi what happens to stagnant water?
Nagkakaroon ng kitikite.
Nagkakaroon siya ng kitikite. Nagiging muddy siya.
Kakasakit ka pa.
Nagkakasakit ka pa. Siya.
Pandemayo.
Oo. Diba? Stagnant lang siya. But you have to be a flowing river.
Yes.
You have to be a flowing river. And when you, pag nakita ka ng flowing river, nung pumunta kami na kayo, pumunta sa mga koke.
Ang koke.
Dati, ganda.
Magigit.
Ganda. Ganda na flowing river. Okay. So we try to be a flowing river. Flowing river in our spiritual life, in our relationship, in our friends, and in our work. It's hard, pero we try. We try. We always try.
Question.
What was your question?
Question. 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 Question.
pwede ba sa stagnation is yung introversy? Introversy?
Pwede mo siya maging excuse. But again, question
kasi
yourself.
Kasi personality mo yun eh.
Pwede siya maging reason. But again, question yourself. Are you doing it for the wrong reason?
Extrovert. Yan ako lang. Yung gina-justify ako ng introvert. Gina-justify ako ng introvert. Introvert ako.
Introvert din ako. Pero if introversy is leading you to being lazy, not attending PA, not attending this, hindi naman... if introversy is holding you back from helping your friend who needs a company right now, sabihin mo ko, tinatulog talaga ako lumabas. Pero kailangan kanya ngayon.
Okay.
Right? So you have to question. You have to analyze yourself. Again, nagagawa to pag nag-examination of conscience tayo, nagpe-prayer tayo, and we ask for guidance.
Okay?
hindi natin to ma-figure out all by ourselves. We need help.
We need help. Like, help.
Okay, stagnation. Good news is, God wants you to be happy. Ayoko niya mag-maintain dun sa whole unhappy old days mo. That's why he gave Christ. That's why there's no actually reason to be sad. Which is argument namin na Emma. Hindi gusto ko yung character mo na sad. Pero hindi pwede maging sad kasi kasi katoliko ka. Okay, so gets ko na yung point niya kung bakit hindi daw pwede maging sad. Yun, okay? Forward to there. So yeah, to be holy is to becoming like God. If we don't become like God, we will only end up frustrated. Because he either image and likeness. For example, isa kong plancha, pero ginamit niya ako as pang toaster ng bread.
Ano ba naman?
Paluto ng itlog.
O sige, bahin ko.
Pang ano?
Plancha?
Nagano mo lang naman eh. Bread is gagawin ko plus bread toast na siya.
Nagano mo ng ano, na...
Butter. Butter.
Pupunta tayo sa plancha. Pero ako, for example, si Joey yung nag-create ng plancha. And sa isip ni Joey, gusto niya yung plancha na yung pangdamit yun. Anong purpose ng plancha na yun? At ginamit niya pang toast bread. E paano kung ilagay ni Joey yun ng aluminum o something na chemical? Right? So how would Joey feel? Joey would feel weird and sad. No, mali yan. I-re-report niya yan. Hindi pa pwede yan. Or otherwise, magkukos pa siya ng chaos. Paano pag may nalason dun sa ginawa nila, i-re-report nila yung creator, si Joey. Diba? So, you are created holy. So ano mangyari pag hindi kayo naging holy? Of course, you will also feel sad.
Misused.
Because that is your nature. That's why. And hindi na kayo basta create your image and likeness of God, which is different from the other creatures. Iba ka from plants and everything. Okay, so ano yung panglaban natin sa unhappy old days? One is go for a clean slate. Clean slate this year, 2018, resolution, etc. Go for confession, go for, pwede kayo mag-spiritual direction after confession. Sabihin nyo lang sa pare. Sabihin nyo, Father, can I go for spiritual direction after confession proper? Iko-close nyo yung confession, tapos pwede mo siyang kausapin anything that you want to talk to him about. Any question, kahit yung mga lame questions, okay lang yun. Go for a clean slate. Because another thing na nakita ko, sabi nung priest, God wants to use you. Ngayon, how can you use someone or something if he's rotten, he's weak? Right? And you also want to offer yourself to God. Diba? So if you want to offer yourself to God, you want to offer yourself to God in a proper way. It's a two-way street. Kung gagawa si God ng paraan for you, kailangan mo rin, you know, your will to be there, to cooperate with grace. Even Pope Francis and the many, many popes and the priests, they still go to confession. They still get advices. Even the saints, meron sila si St. Augustine, si St. Ambrose, yung kanyang father of aspect with father. Marami pa. Ano mo yung Grace pala? Sige. Do you have any idea what is Grace?
It's a keyword.
Ayan. Ayan na siya. It's a keyword. Tawa sa dito. Okay, Grace, isa yan. Katulad siya ng holiness, medyo abstract siya kasi wala siyang mukha. Yung Grace. Wala siyang image. Kaya isa siyang spiritual favor na ginawa sa'yo to help you out. To help you in your struggling. This is through the Holy Spirit and the sacraments. Kaya na five word dati yung sacraments. Go to Mass. Go to confession. That's the basic. Grace is a favor, the free and undeserved help that God gives to respond to His call. Pag tinawag, yun ang maganda kay God kasi, tinatawag ka niya, pero hindi kayo tatawagin lang. Wala akong help. He will give you all the needs, the need, anything that you need for you to be there. And what we strive for is to be on the state of that grace. Any state of grace. Condition siya of a person who is free from mortal sin. Siguro alam niyo kung ano yung mortal sin. Right? Mortal sin. And is pleasing to God. It is a state of being in God's friendship and the necessary condition for the soul at death in order to attain heaven. Okay. Yun yung basic context ng state of grace. Pag narinig nyo siya sa iba, it could be called sanctifying grace. Iba yung tawag dyan. But it's pretty much the same. Ito yung state kung saan ang soul mo ay hindi na nababagabag. Hindi siya nababagabag kasi full of hope ka. You know that you are at God's embrace. And you have no mortal sin. Two, make your goals aligned to holiness. We align our goals through gift of discernment, surrendering our intentions to God. Ginamit ko natin ang visualization to before, yung rose window. Kasi yung rose window, and sa gitna niya is si Christ. And it's basically how our life should be. You have to find your center, which is Christ, and then you put everything around it. Lahat, your work, your thoughts, your friends. Why is it necessary to find the center? The explanation of Bishop Barron about it is because we, right? If you go at the edge of the wheel, well, dito mo nilagay yung center mo, dyan. Pag umikot yung wheel, bababa ka ng sobrang bongga. Pag nilagay mo siya dito, imbalance ka. Diba? Pag umiikot yung wheel, mag-imbalance ka. But, if you put yourself in the center, kahit gumuho yung mundo mo, paikot-ikot yung mundo mo, you will be stable. Kasi, your center is Christ. That's his explanation of why the rose gold. And, kapag pupunta kayo ng mga church, and makita yung rose gold, hindi siya dinesign lang just for that. Yun talaga yung meaning niya. Meron siyang theological importance. Merong rose gold sa Novena ba? St. Peter.
Peter.
So you can go there and gaze at the rose gold and then you can pray there actually. And then you can, pwede mo na siyang matawag as keeping the presence of God. You just gaze. Lord, can you be my center? I want that. Gusto ko kasi ikaw yung center. And another thing about this is, maganda siya, di ba? Ganda. Nag-radiate yung light. Ganun din kapag when we center Christ to our life. It's full of harmony. It's full of balance. It's full of color. Nag-radiate ka. So, reminder to put your goals aligned to what God wants us. Number three is grow in the Holy Spirit. Prayer. There are many ways to grow in the Holy Spirit. Isa na yung sacraments, prayer, yung oral prayer nyo, rosary, ganyan. But the very, very basic talaga is prayer. You cannot listen. You cannot reach that goal if you don't pray. Kasi you have to be constantly in touch with Him. Okay? you have to be in cooperation with grace. Until you reach that point na your life is not about you anymore. It's about Christ living your life. Pag na-attain na natin yung state na yun. one of the holiest people I know is Mama Mary. Do you agree?
Yes.
That's really good. And realize Mama Mary is full of grace. Nag-uumapaw siya sa grace. So kung pwede lang iturok yung grace dito every day. Injection ko sa sarili ko. Para lang makapunta ka dun sa state. But the good thing is, again, we have the sacraments to do it. Mama Mary is a great fiat. Eh, yung kanyang pinaka-famous na mantra is, your will, which is
fiat.
Latin ba? Diba? Magagamit din natin yung within our lives always. Fiat, your will be done. Pray ka na marami. Sabihin mo na lahat na sabihin mo, tapos sa huli sabihin mo, but your will be done.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen, your will be done.
Mama Mary, also, eh, sabi nga ni Shane kanina, ang hirap lang maging saint. Kasi parang, yun nga, ang daming sacrifice, ganyan. Totoo naman. Yung ginagawa ko, ang hirap pala nito. Ang hirap. Kasi, super ano siya eh. No? It's full of challenges. Pero, diba? Ang hirap, ano ba? Pero ito yung napansin, in observation sa mga saints, hindi sila perfect. And hindi sila by checklist na, perfect ito. No. Ang nangyari sa kanila is parang, si St. Augustine, nagpa-convert na siya, deathbed niya na yun. Doon lang siya bininyaga na sa Catholic, right? And marami pang iba. So it's the same with us. And the important thing is you keep on bouncing back. Bounce ka nang bounce back. When you fall, bounce back. When you have mistake, bounce back. Pero wag mo na mong isipin na, di, okay lang, confession na lang ako, gawin ko ito. Ibang usapan naman yun, okay? Nakapanbawin na lang ako, gano'n. Pag-isipan mo yan ulit kung pwede ba yung ganyang situation. Okay. Being a saint may sound hard, but the good news is you have all the help you need. And you have your father you can talk to get you there. Kagawa ka lang na isang step. It's easier said than done, pero
like obedient children, do not act in compliance with the desires of your former self. As he who called you is holy, be holy yourselves in every aspect of your conduct. Be holy because I am holy. Cillian Blois, isa siyang Catholic writer siya. Lagi siyang nire-reference sa mga bishop na napapalit ko. Sabi niya kasi, the only real sadness is not to be a saint. Sabi niya. It's not being na-fire ka. Sige, syempre all those little sad things, right? Pero as a Catholic, as a Christian, the most frustrating and sad thing is not to be a saint. Not to find that love that you deserve from God. Because that is your original design. Plan siya ka eh. Like a toaster. So, yeah. Find what is your original self. Mahirap siya kasi na nabuhay tayo sa earth eh. Nabuhay tayo sa earth, di ba?
But now.
Oh,
but
alam mo, one time nung college ako, tinanong ko yun sa isang police, sabi ko, di ba na-attain mo na naman yung kasi police ka na? Oo. Di ba na-attain mo na yung parang holiness kasi mukha? Kasi nga priest nga siya, iniisip ko holiness siya. Tapos sabi ko, di mo nalang gusto mamatay. Iyon ako siya. Father, don't you wanna just die?
Tapos you know, ang sagot niya sa akin, no. Because he wants to serve, because he wants to serve Jesus. And that phrase changed my life after noon. Yung moment na yung Father sends, hindi ko makalimutan kasi sa UST church yun, and very, very rare, yun yung first, sa apat na taon ko doon, yun yung first and last time ko nakakita ng priest na ang ginagawa niya yung prayer niya sa likod. Eh, diba usually nasa private yan sila, okay, nasa harapan sila ng pew. Pero si Father Senso, nandun siya sa pinakalikod, yung mismong entrance na pew. Tapos yung time na yun, super frustrated ako about faith and everything. So, nakakita ko ng priest, makaganyan siya. So, nadala niya yung book niya na black. Matanda na talaga siya. Tapos kinamusap ko siya, tinanong ko lang siya about that basic question. Kasi I got tired yun. Ko, bakit ganito? Bakit, di ba, pag natin mo yung home, so hindi mo matay ka nga lang. Para tapos na. Ang dark masyado. O, di ba? So, kasi alam mo, just maghihirap ka, sacrifice, mga nalang. Pero hindi pala ganun yun. Hindi pala ganun. Kasi you have to serve Christ. And especially, your body of Christ. And hindi lang naman isang parte ng body of Christ. You have your brothers and sisters to help them to get to Christ rin. That reason of mine is very selfish. That is very selfish. That is escapism. You're trying to escape the pain. Not realizing that the pain has purpose. And he, again, you will not realize all these things kung wala kang spiritual direction, wala kang prayer. You don't have those basic things. Submitting yourself to God. Submitting yourself to be scrutinized, to be corrected. So hopefully, this year, we can find our ultimate goal as a saint. Diyosa ka dun, ate!
Diyosa ka, naging perfect.
Meron, nandun sa kabila. See you there. Hindi ko makikita nyo, baka pag, kung sakaling mo magkita tayo sa purgatorio, nung pag narealize ko pa yung sarili nyo sa purgatorio, baka makita nyo ako dun sa lazy area. So, yun ako nagtulog. Hindi, ganyan, magubay doon ako. Iaayos ko yung sarili ko. Ayun. Yun. Tapos na, Tito. Okay, so, maybe we try to end for a short prayer. Ito na lang po na lang tayo. Let's pour ourselves in the most holy presence of God, Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, thank you so much for this wonderful time both to talk about you. Thank you for the happiness and the laughter we have, hoping that we enjoy your presence today. Lord, we offer to you all our families, and Lord, as we examine ourselves, help us to see the things that we still need to improve, and help us to do our improvement, because it's very, very hard. Help us to get back to our prayer time. Just talking to you, looking at you, glancing at you would be enough. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Ayun, so, Amen. Tita, may